sunny, and Sunny has been in our training program for quite some time. He's doing phenomenal with all of his basic obedience. He can hold our place command for about 25 minutes, maybe a little bit longer. We can probably push that. He's doing very good with that, as well as his count and weight. He has thumbs down pat, sit down, of course. He walks phenomenal on a leash. He's just all around a really great pup. Very laid back energy, great with kids, everyone. So Sunny is an all around really, really good boy. So what we did decide to do is add to his commands list, and I wanted to keep training fun for him and keep him engaged. So because he's very gentle, I did teach him the shake command. So I know in the beginning of training, we always say not to roll over that batting behavior, but now that he's a little bit more mature, we can have it where he understands only when he's asked. So if he paws at me when I don't ask for it and say, no treat. But if I say shake, is when he gets it. So I'm going to tell him shake. Yes, good boy. Give him that treat, good boy. We started working on this earlier in the week, so he's kind of figured it out now. Sit. Good boy. Down. Good boy. And the reason I'm introducing or doing this while doing other commands is in case he tries to like bat at me, I don't want him to think that it's acceptable to kind of beg or have a batting behavior only if asked for it. So shake. Good boy. Good job.
Sit. Shake. Good boy.
Good job. Good.
Sit. Good boy. And because I didn't
ask for it, I'm going to tell him good boy because he didn't even try and lift that foot. So that's exactly what I want from him. Can I sit?
Good boy.
Hope you can see this. I'm going to try and have you turn towards the camera a bit more. Sun, sun. Sit. Shake. Good boy. Good job. So I'm going to actually get down on his level. I've been working on this in a chair with him as well because I want him to understand, again, not to have any batting behaviors. So I'm going to sit here for a moment and see if he's going to try to bat at me. Good boy. I want to avoid that calm behavior. So I'm actually going to turn so you can see his little feet. Sit. Shake.
Good boy.
And the reason I'm so show how great his temperament truly is and how good he has for manners. So shake. Good boy. I'm going to soon introduce other foot or other paw. But right now, I just want to understand when I say shake, he can give me that foot, whichever one he wants.
I'm just ripping up these treats into
really small pieces and rewarding that calm behavior. I'm going to pet his belly to kind of bat at me at all.
Shake. Shake. You get that focus back. He is
really wants this treat. So there we go. Good boy. I'm going to wait it out, just like I would with any other command. And the reason for that is, with any command, whether it's a trick, down, or whether it's a trick, or just a basic obedience command itself, I don't want to repeat it, or else it does lose meaning. So if I'm sitting here saying shake, 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 over and over, it's just like if I was doing that with him when he was younger, with the sit command or anything like that. As you see, he's super gentle, taking treats from me, licking and nibbling. Not using my fingers at all. Sunny's a really, really good boy. Very gentle, gentle pup. Down. A little distraction. Give that focus right back. Down. Good boy. Oh, almost.
Good boy.
Good job. So I'm actually going to get up. We're going to do a couple more of those shakes. And then I'm going to actually first grab a couple more treats. And then we will do this as we do with any other command. And session always ending on a good note. So we're going to get Sunny's attention. Sunny, sit. Good boy. Sunny, shake. Good boy. Good job.
Good job. Good boy. Oh, he did drop the tree.
Give him a second for that. Come here, mister. There you go.
And again, if he tried to
bat at me, all I'm going to do is, like with any other command for a correction, I'm just going to say, Sunny. Good boy. Sit. Let me try and see if I can entice him to bat. Because I didn't ask him again. I said, uh-uh. I'm trying to look at him a little bit more. Sorry. I'm trying to see if the trainer over here has anything good for him. Sit. Shake. Good boy. Like, I'm only rewarding it when I ask for it. If I don't ask for it, I'm going to say, uh-uh. Let me see if I can entice again. I need the batting in here rather than shake. Shake. Good boy. He's doing really good with it, so I'm very happy with how quickly he's picking it up. Down. And the next step will be to introduce him other foot or other paw. Sit. Good boy. Good job.
Shake.
Good.
And as I said, he's doing really,
really well with all of his disciplines. Sit. Shake.
Good boy. And so therefore we're continuing
to practice all of those commands, but introducing something new like the shake command to keep things fun and engaging for not just Sunny, myself, or any other trainers who want to work with him, and as well as when he goes home. It's a really great fun thing for kids to do. Is have a pup that wants to do extra things and tricks. So I'm going to end as always on his strongest hands. And should probably do one more shake. Shake. Good boy, you reward that.
Give that treat, there we go. I'm going to tell him down.
Good. And then his strongest command.
This sit.
Sit. Good boy. And lots and lots of praise. So Sunny has an amazing pup, really, really great feedback. He's a great temperament, phenomenal with kids, and he's doing great with all his basic obedience, including his